Welcome back to the Ice for Kids Arena in Fort Francis, where we are just about ready to drop the puck about 15 minutes earlier than expected, Mr. Bolstad. But
we got on there.
That's right. That's right. Glad we got in what we did.
I'm trying to figure out that goal. Is that 47?
Batty Bliss? Yes.
Yeah, that makes sense.
It will be. So, again, St. Thomas Aquinas Saints from Kenora in to face the hometown Fort Francis Muskies Norwasa girls hockey action. Muskies 2-0 in Norwasa play so far. St. Thomas Aquinas trying to take over top spot in the division, and we are underway. Coming across the right wing for the Muskies, it's Courtney McCoy. She gets a weak shot in on net, partially deflected. Puck in behind the net. McCoy, a shot off the side of the net. Now Marley Bliss with it behind the net for the Muskies. Bliss trying to center it, deflects high in the air, trying to knock it down. The Muskies do get possession. Bliss puts it off the right-hand boards, in behind the net, and back for it there. For St. Thomas Aquinas, it's Samantha Neal. Now four-person battle for the puck. Neal comes away with it. She gets it up ahead to Addie Greer. Greer's going to get it out across the line, puts it up the center. That hits a skate, bounces away. Muskies will get it, put it back into the Saints zone. They'll pull off a quick change, and the Saints will try and bring the puck out to center. Puck, though, slapped back into the Saints end by Avery Sinclair, number three for the Muskies. Saints recover it in their own zone, put it off the boards, but not out. Kept in by Isabel Tangay. She puts it towards the net, deflected wide by Carson McQuaker of the Muskies. Muskies try and bring it out of the corner. Saints, though, take over and bring it up, and it's Heidi Petura for the Saints. Trying to put it out. It's going to be delayed offside against the Muskies as they could not quite keep it in. 1:16 gone here in the opening period. No score. And we do have some starting lines, Mr. Bolstad.
Yeah, goalie Madison Bliss, and you can go the D up here.
Absolutely. Your defenseman Blair Cross and Ophelia Lucas Engberg. Starting forwards were Marley Bliss, Hannah Pope, and Courtney McCoy.
Again, brought to you by Jay's Auto Repair. Welcome to Ice for Kids Arena. Joey Payer on the lead call. Mike Bolson kind of playing along, and it should be a good one tonight.
We always love these surprise starts here, the beauty of live radio. But again, folks, advertisements all over town said 7:15. Loose puck in front. Glove down, but a glove hand pass going from Kira Farrington of the Muskies to Carson McQuaker in front. McQuaker thought she had a shot for a tap-in goal, but whistled down immediately by the officials. Faceoff will come outside of the Saints blue line. 1:30 gone here in the opening period. It's going to be Hayden Allum taking the draw for the Muskies, going up against Maddie Hughes. Puck sent into the Saints zone and back for it for the Saints. It is Jalen Gerard, number 18. Puck's going to come out now down the left wing side, moved ahead by Greer. She puts it into the Muskie zone. Racing back for it is Sienna Tom of the Muskies. She turns it over inside the blue line. Greer puts it in behind the net. Chasing after it there is the captain of the Muskies, number 10, Jersey Calder. Back for her victory lap year this year. It's a grade 12 last year, but here in Ontario, you're allowed that victory lap if you so choose. Come back and take a few extra courses and get one more year of athletics in. Calder decided to do so, and that was a huge decision on the for the Muskies' chances this year, as Calder is a linchpin back there on the blue line for Fort Francis. Puck sent down into the St. Thomas zone. Back for it is Delaney Turner. Turner's got it. She wheels around her own net. Sends it up front to Jordan Sundin. Sundin, she's stopped at the blue line momentarily by Hannah Pope. Muskies now take it over, bringing it on the right wing side. It's Courtney McCoy. She's bothered there by Molly Hendy of the Saints, but stays with the puck. Now McCoy comes right out in front. Save by loose puck in front. Still there as Jordan Moen couldn't quite find the rebound. Moen, the starting netminder for the St. Thomas Aquinas Saints, and she's had the Muskies number as of late, both in last year's semifinal, holding steady in that shootout to get the win and eliminate Fort Francis, and then also winning the shootout out in the Emory Arena during the Scott Clendenning Memorial Tournament Championship Final earlier this preseason. Muskies look to move the puck into the zone. Hustling after it is Emma Wilson, number 15. Wilson's got it. She's trying to get around the net. Bothered there by Riley Kipling. Leaves it there behind the net. Picking it up now. Trying to center it. Sailor Easton. That pass missed everyone. Greer's going to get it on the far side. Muskies will keep it in, though. Send it back into the left wing corner. And here's Wilson with it behind the net. Wilson now leaves it for Easton. Easton tried to backhand it. Now gets it right back under stick. Goes to the net. The backhander. And that deflects just wide Chasing after it now is Bella, Jersey Rose making her season debut for the Muskies. Number 11. Here's Easton now. She gets taken down as Neal got a piece of her going by. Puck, though, kept in the Saint zone. Sent in deep again by Tange. Muskies will pull off a partial change. Saints, though, will pick it up, send it up to the blue line. And moving it out now, it's Sophie Muse. Muse, she tries to send it into the Muskie zone. That was stopped up at the line. Sent back out to the neutral zone. Neal will get it. Put it right back into the forward end. Farrington now up to the left wing side to Bella Fry. Fry, one of the five impressive newcomers on this Muskie team, one of the four grade nines. Saints, though, get a chance. Here's Reese Rohde, the dangerous speedster for the Saints. She's got the puck in the Muskie zone. Looked to make a move on Fry, but had it taken off her stick. And Farrington's going to bring it back the other way. Farrington puts it in deep, gets past Durard, chases after him behind the net. Tried to center it, goes off the base of the net. Go back to the point. Calder will keep it there. Keep it in there. Sends it towards the left circle to Farrington, taking off her stick. And the Saints will bring it right back out. And coming up the left-hand side now. And the shot on goal, save by Maddie Bliss. It's Ayla Savage getting that shot off. Turner will keep it in. Calder grabs it in the left corner. Calder now working against two forecheckers of the Saints. Farrington there to help her out. She's being bodied there, though, by Madden Hughes. Four players now piled in the corner. Saints come away with it. Tried to drive the net. That was Rohde, but knocked off her stick at the last second in front by Calder. Nice defensive play there by the Muskie captain. Calder's got it now in her own zone. Oh, cross ice to Tom. Tom has it taken away from her, and now here comes Hughes. Left circle. Hughes. She has to spin back. Sends it around. Tried to send it around behind the net. She gets it now over to Kiana Edison, number 24. Sent in front. Hit a body and dropped right down in the crease, but sent down and out by the Muskies, and it's going to be an icing call. 5:52 gone here in the opening period. Still no score.
Now we do have Zero's scoreboard update brought to you by Norland Oil of Emo. Easy to find, located just off Highway 11 in Emo. Convenience store and your source for bulk and retail fuel. Stop by and see Paul Koomans today. Nice guy, great business. Thank you, Norland Oil.
Puck in the Muskies in off the draw. Trying to move it ahead now. It's Ella Evans. She's pinned along the left side boards, though, by Sundin. Puck sent around the boards. Moved out across the line and down into the Saints' end. Chasing after it is Kipling. She's being watched there by Evans. Kipling and Evans chasing under the puck. Coming in to help is Marissa Kenny of the Muskies. Puck goes cross ice. Neal tries to dump it out. Now the Saints do get it out to center. And down to the Muskie end. Back for it is Lucas Engberg. She's being watched by Sundin. Lucas Engberg taken off the puck by Sundin. Knocked down. Sundin steals momentarily. Tries to put it out front. Lucas Engberg gets it back, though, and she'll get it out. Good forechecking hustle there, though, by Jordan Sundin of the Saints. Now, here is the Saints captain, Addie Greer. She dumps it partially into the Muskie zone. Can't get it deep, though. Marley Bliss trying to find the puck on the left wing side, centering around behind the net. And now chasing after it, there is Sinclair. She goes off the glass, down the ice. No icing on the play. And back for it is Durard. Durard, watched by Pope. She sends it around the boards. Muskie's going to pinch and keep this puck in for a minute, but coming away with it now is Greer. Greer to center. She'll just send it in deep, then spin back and head for a change. Here's Farrington with the puck for the Muskies in behind the net. She's going to try and send it up the center. She does, and here's Fry. Fry looks to move it across the line. She's got three Saints on her. And St. Thomas Aquinas gets the puck back. Hughes trying to move it ahead. Farrington pickpockets her, though. Puck still inside the Muskie line. Farrington and Hughes and Greer trying to get it loose. Now Hughes gets it in front to Rohde, but taken off her stick by Calder. Rohde gets it back, though. Sends it in behind the net, around the boards. Fry races after it. Tried to get up to McQuaker. That was intercepted. Hughes has got it on the left wing boards. Hughes sends it in behind the net. Rohde's got it there. Rohde sets up in the right corner. Trying to pass the puck out front. That's blocked. Hughes comes in to help. Moves it to Rohde. Calder trying to take her off the puck. Rohde, a fierce competitor for the Saints. She comes away with it. Tries to come out of the corner. The shot stopped by Maddie Bliss. Puck put off the boards and out of play. And Reese Rohde causing all kinds of havoc in the Fort Francis zone, but nothing to show for it as of yet. 8:22 gone here in the first period. No score.
That's timeout brought to you by Lowry's. We think of our customers as business partners, and we're here to help you accomplish your goals. In business since 1905, that gives us a reason to stop in and say hi. Located on Scott Street, thank you to Lowry's for supporting Muskie hockey.
Muskies trying to get control of the draw in their own zone. They will move it out to center. Stopped up at the line. Get another shot. Cross. She's intercepted. She'll try again. Gets it just out across. And Saints are offside as it was Sundin falling down in the zone. So she's got to clear the territory. Puck set back into the Saints zone. And this is Neal with it. Neal moves it up ahead. And here's Easton with it. Easton. Cross ice. Tangay's got it. Neutral zone. Sundin races to the puck, tried to put it in, couldn't do it. Tangay moves it ahead. Puck is sent now down deep into the Muskie end, and that'll be icing with 9:06 gone in the first. And Mike, before I get myself in trouble,
You already are in trouble if you have to say that. I know, I'm already in trouble.
You've
got to talk about the other station.
Well, I should do that, I guess, since they're being good enough to take me on board as well. This is Muskie Girls Hockey brought to you by Holman Financial tonight on Home TV. Thank you so much for tuning in online. Sorry, did not get a chance to mention you. I think the whole starting early thing threw me for a loop and forgot to get our second broadcast entity in. But Home TV folks, thank you so much for watching online here tonight. Hoping to bring you a great game here from the Ice for Kids Arena.
I think it's awesome what you guys are doing with that video. Tonight.
Oh, hey,
it's
you
great.
Know what?
Good job, guys.
It's a big thing for those folks that aren't in the area that can tune in, or relatives from far away that
Absolutely.
Can tune in as well. Great stuff, and we're glad to have them along, as well as all of you listening on KSDM tonight as well, Lynx Country 104. Here's Greer with the puck at center, moves it ahead to Savage, that goes off her stick. Muskies retrieve it, sit back into the Saints zone. It's kind of been almost a game of catch between the two teams for a good part of the period, from one blue line to the other, but not too much happening.
It reminds me of last year's game. That was like a 1-1 game.
Yeah, 1-1, go for it, got to that shootout. Yeah, it's very tight defensive hockey, so. Here's McCoy now. She's going to put it off the glass, moves it ahead into the Saints' end, bounces over the stick of Bliss, and Turner's back for it. Turner moves it far side to Greer. That's intercepted. Here's McCoy, walks in, fires just wide. Courtney McCoy with a great shot from the slot, but fired the puck just outside the left side post. One of the best chances for the Muskies so far. Now, stoppage in play. We also had a glove hand there, possibly, called down. So we're going to bring that faceoff outside of the Saints' zone with 9:34 remaining here in the open period.
Kind of not a lot of great scoring opportunities. I guess not unexpected. Both defensive cores are very good. So, yeah, I guess, you know, it's good fun hockey to watch, though, Joey.
Absolutely. Puck deep in the Muskie end. This is Callie Greer, trying to track it down for the Saints. So two Greers on this Saints team. We got Captain Addy as well as sister Callie. Saints with a puck in the neutral zone, moves it ahead. Now here's Rohde. Rohde working against four Muskie defenders. Boy, they're all over the speedy veteran forward. They know how much of a threat she can be offensively for the Saints, and they were not letting her get any traction going on in the zone on that rush. Now here's Carson McQuaker, sending in deep in behind the Saints zone. Helped out by Fry. Saints grab it, trying to wing it around the boards. Coming to the far side, it's knocked out and ahead by Molly Hendy. Muskie's trying to retrieve it in neutral ice. Edison tries to backhand it into the Muskie zone. That's sent right back out. And back for it is Courtney Neal. Or Samantha Neal, apologies. Samantha Neal, number 4 for St. Thomas Aquinas. She moves around the left wing side to Molly Hendy. That goes off her stick. And Tom gets it, puts it back in the Saints zone. And it's hit right back out. Very tight defensive hockey between these two teams. And that's to be expected, as they know that the margin of error is so slim for victory when you've got two teams as evenly matched as this. You don't want to be given any breathing room to that opposition. And we've certainly seen that style of play from both sides so far. There's a chance in front. Easton on a one-timer after the feed sent to her in front by Jersey Rose. Save by Jordan Moen. Now Hendy with it for the Saints. Up the left wing side. Moves it up to Muse. Puck stripped away from her, and it's Emma Wilson for the Muskies. Wilson down the right wing side. She'll send it in deep into the Saints end. Derard chases after it. Watched by Allum. Derard now. She'll go far side. Over to Heidi Patera. Patera up to Muse. That puck is kept in, though. Saints will try regroup and try and bring it out again. But Evans blocking the clearing attempt of Patera. Now the Saints get something going. Sending up ahead to Addie Greer. Greer, she'll dump it in deep and chase after it against Lucas Engberg. Lucas Engberg wins the race to the puck, moves it to Kenny. Kenny now working hard against, looks like Hughes on the far sides for the Saints. Hughes in there battling for it. Kenny gets it, can't quite get it out. Lucas Engberg will have to chase back behind her net and try again. Muskies send it up and out to center. Trying to pick it up is Allum. That was hacked down with a high stick by Hughes. And play whistled down. 6:44 left here in the first period. We remain scoreless.
Thank you for listening from the West End Motors Press.
Marley Bliss taking the draw for the Muskies against Maddie Hughes. Muskies win it. Tangay gets it. Sent and now bashed into the zone by Hannah Pope. McCoy tries to track it down in the right side corner. Bliss in there as well, working against two Saints. Pope's got it in behind the net now. Pope, centering pass! Oh, just under the stick of Bliss and cleared away at the last second by the Saints. Rohde now. She'll move it out to center. Rohde in across the line on the right wing. These are for Hughes. Hughes taken down. Nice physical play there by Marley Bliss. Now, McCoy gets it. Can't get past Alexa Hoots at the left point. Muskies grab it, though, send it back in deep. They'll do a full change. And with less than 6 minutes to go, the Saints will try a rush up ice. That is stopped up by Bella Fry, though, at the blue line. Now put back in the neutral zone. Backhanded in by Farrington. And now the Saints have it. McQuaker, though, trying to pinch in to keep it in. She can't. Puck sent out to center. Here's Calder with it. Calder, she's got a head of steam going. She gets a rush going the right wing side. Calder looking to work her way around Hughes. She gets in behind the net. Jersey Calder activating from her defense position. She'll keep it on the left wing boards. Now send it in behind the net. Racing in after it is Farrington. Farrington. She'll grab it on the right wing boards. Looking for help. Doesn't have any coming though. And Hughes will get it out, put it off the boards, and then head off for a change. Calder now, starting in her own zone. Long pass ahead, just off the stick of McQuaker. She deflects it lightly to the Saints blue line. Hendy picks it up for St. Thomas Aquinas. And the Saints put it in the Muskie end. Sienna Tom puts it around the boards, but Hendy intercepts. Now Sundin for the Saints. Center tried to center it. That went off the base of the net. And now a chance. Down the left wing side. Here comes Bella Fry with a chance. Walking in. Shot. Score!
All righty.
Bella Fry giving the hometown side the lead here in the showdown for first as her partial breakaway goal finds a way through Jordan Bowen. And with 4:40 to go in the first period, the Muskies take a 1-0 lead.
What I liked about the whole thing, when she got the puck down that left side, she got close to net, she was kind of getting angled off. She lowered her right shoulder, buried it in. That's a very tough thing to learn. She did it very well and buries that puck 1-0 for Francis.
And that is
very
a
impressive.
Grade 9 freshman doing that, which you got to believe that bodes well for the future for this Muskie program when they're doing that kind of thing in grade 9.
Puck protection and things like that, Joey, are just instinctual things. Unfortunately, we have to teach it. I don't think Bella Fry's had to be taught that. That's natural.
That's natural skill there. Boy, and she's tough for a smaller player. She's got a lot of toughness about her. No quit in her. And she put that puck right on net.
I'm going to send a shout out.
Okay.
Greg Ross and Monty Ross and your dad and mom were out the other night. Saw them at Border Bar during Vikings trivia. And boy, Mr. and Mrs. Ross, you guys look absolutely fabulous. And Greg and Monty, thank you for getting them out. I wish every day my mom and dad were around. And when I saw how happy they were together and how much fun they were having. But God bless you. And Thanks for making my night, the Ross family.
That is awesome. Cheers to the Ross family. Those Ross boys.
They were good, fun players to play against.
Pretty good. Well, their sons too, Nolan and Davis.
Yeah, I heard they were good.
They did some good
twins.
Things here for the Lakers, and then also for the Portage Terriers. I believe it was Nolan that was on the CJHL National Championship winning team a few years back.
Cool. Let's get back to the game. Got you off your game.
So that's all right. Muskie's got a too many players on the ice penalty, so they are killing that off right now. 5-on-4. McCoy gets the puck, though, trying to send the puck out of the zone, and she gets it out there. That goal-scoring play again, it was Bella Fry. Assist to Carson McQuaker at the 15-20 mark to give that Muskies that 1-0 lead. Now they're trying to kill off this Saints power play. Puck deflects off a skate, goes right on goal to Maddie Bliss. She covers up and holds on for the faceoff. 1:07 left in the power play for the Saints. 3:30 left here in the first period.
Of course we have.
Shot sent toward the net, goes just wide. Tracking it down in the corner, it's Callie Greer. She's working against McQuaker. Now in behind the net, back to the right point. And this is Alexa Houts with the puck. Houts keeps it at the right-hand side. Sent around by Sundin. In behind to Rohde. She's got Callie Greer in front. Rohde makes a move against Calder in the right-wing corner. Puts it back to Houts at the right point. The shot blocked. And now maybe a breakaway chance. Kira Farrington trying to get a step on Houts. Walking in across the line. Goes to the back end. Leaves it for McQuaker, who can't get a shot off. Farrington, though, stays after the puck. Sends it in deep. And a good chance there for the Muskies. Farrington almost busting clear. Yeah. Was angled off by two Saints defenders and left it for McQuaker, who almost got a shot off as well. Good penalty kill here, though, for the Muskies. Just 10 seconds left in the Saints power play. 2:30 remaining in the first period. And Fort Francis on a goal by Bella Fry leads 1-0 in this battle for first place in Norwassa. Allum gets it out across the line. A penalty is over, so St. Thomas Aquinas 0-for-1 on the power play so far tonight. Muskies now move it into the Saints' end. Derard backhands it to Muse. Muse gets it out across the Saints' line. Checked there by Kenny. Now she stays after it. Muse moving up along with Savage. Muse cuts to the middle. Tried to get around Lucas Engberg. That didn't work. She slammed the door shut and cleared the puck out into the Saints' end. Derard back, watched by Ella Evans. Evans. She knocks it down, left wing corner. Marley Bliss comes in to help. Puck loose along the left wing boards. Bliss wins the battle to the puck. Working against the Saints D. Muskie go for a bit of a change there, kind of left Bliss hanging on that one. Puck sent in on goal, pad saved by Maddie Bliss, rather. Sent around behind the net. We have 1:22 left here in the first. Sinclair for the Muskies in behind the net. She's bothered there by Hughes. Good forecheck here put on by this Saints line of Rohde, Hughes, and Savage. Muskies trying to come away with the puck, right wing corner. Shot, puck shot behind the net. McCoy's got it. 1 minute to go here in the first. Muskies up 1-0. Hughes sends it to the left wing board to Rohde. Rohde trying to set up a play, watched by Sinclair. Trying to center it in front as Addie Greer got a stick on it but put it just wide. Her and Tange having a pitched battle in front of Maddie Bliss as the two teams showing their dislike for one another here. Pucks in all the way down the ice. Icing call, 33.4 seconds left in the period. Faceoff will be back down in the Muskie end.
Again, we always talk about the first minute and the last minute of each period. This is very crucial. Fort Francis will have a defensive zone coverage faceoff here. And again, very important part of the game.
It'll be Hughes for the Saints taking on Farrington. Farrington wins it, gets it to Tom. Tom will move it to Calder. Calder, she'll spin away from Rohde. Go back around the other side to Tom. Tom goes off the boards. Tried to hit McQuaker, that pass missed. Houts gets it at center. Now Farrington backhands it to the line. And here's Rohde with it. 15 seconds to go. Rohde sends it in deep. Tom back for it. Moves it over to Calder. Calder being watched closely by Hughes. Puts her over to Fry. Fry gets it near the line and out, and that's going to do it for the opening period. So a very, very tight defensive battle between the two teams, but it's Bella Fry busting loose on a partial breakaway, held strong, got the shot off, and somehow squeezed it through Saints goalie Jordan Moen for the only goal of the contest so far to give the Muskies that early advantage. For those of you watching on home TV, we are going to say please come on back for the second period. Muskie Girls Hockey brought to you by Homeland Financial. We'll be back with you shortly with the second period. And for the rest of you, are we going right into, well, okay. Hope, betcha. But, absolutely. Now, there you go. No. We have two games going simultaneously tonight. The Muskie boys playing the Lake of the Woods Bears simultaneously, same time. More, I'm going to add to that vocabulary. I say simultaneously. It's, there you go. There you go. I say a boot too, how about that? There you go. So anyway, we got the Muskie boys playing Lake of the Woods in the 52 Canadians Arena right now at this same time. We only have the one Zamboni. Not sure if that Zamboni is being used at the moment over in the boys' end, but we are going to forego any kind of ice clearing here between periods of this important Norwasa regular season game. And this is a first for me, folks. Have not witnessed this before, but we are gonna go right into second period action. And we are back with you on Home TV, Muskie Girls Hockey, brought to you by Holman Financial, and here on Lakes Country 104. So second period underway. Muskies hold a 1-0 lead on the goal by Bella Fry, coming at the 15-20 mark, assisted by Carson McQuaker, to give the Muskies that 1-0 edge. Puck deep in the Muskies' end. Lucas Engberg's going to send it around the board zone to McCoy. He's going to try and work the puck out. Good forecheck, though, being put on by the Saints. They were strengthening this part of the game late in the first, and now here early in the second. Centering pass! Hughes tried to get a stick on it, but she was tied up by Blair Cross, and the weak shot just finding its way to Maddie Bliss in the Muskie net. She holds on for the faceoff. 40 seconds gone here in the second period. 1-0 Muskies. Faceoff will be to the right of Bliss. It is Sophie Muse taking the draw for the Saints. She loses it, though. Muskies come away with it as McQuaker sends it up ahead to center. That pass misses. Turner gets it and moves it up the right wing side to Savage. She's stripped of the puck by Tangay. Gets it around to McQuaker. McQuaker taking off her stick as the Saints keeping up this forecheck pressure. Addie Greer in there doing the job this time. Now puck sent towards the net. Muskies get it, send it out to center. And it'll be Delaney Turner picking it up there for St. Thomas Aquinas. Moving it ahead now to Savage. Savage chasing it in behind the net, trying to center it. Knocked away, and Fry's going to pick it up. Bella Fry, the goal scorer. Tries to move it in on the left wing side. Good play by Delaney Turner to stand her up at the line, take the puck off her. Now Saints trying to move it in. Addie Greer's going to just send it in deep and head off with a change along with Savage. Muskies grab it, Sinclair. She'll go cross ice out to neutral zone. Turner picks it up there, moves into the Muskie end. Tangay grabs it. Saints send it in deeper though. Now Sinclair's got it for the Muskies. Sinclair around the boards to Kenny. She can't get it out. Saints applying some serious pressure here early in the second. Trying to center it was Zavea White. Set towards the net, goes just wide. Centering pass again, that goes off a skate. Here's a backhander by Sundin, and that goes just wide of the net. Muskies now under pressure, bring it out to center. Here's Fry, moving in, one player back. Oh, nice work there by Jalen Derard. Standing up to Fry, stealing the puck right off her, and killing that opportunity for the Muskies. Here's Evans now, though. She's going to try and move it ahead to Kenny. Couldn't connect on that pass. And the Saints will move it deep into the Muskie end where they'll chase back for it. 2.5 minutes gone here in the second period. Fort Francis 1, St. Thomas Aquinas nothing. Turnover inside the line by Tenge. Here comes Rohde. The pass across. And a nice play by Jersey Calder as Hughes was wide open on the left wing side. But Calder tipped the pass away and sent it to safety as the Muskies get it down deep into the Saints' end. Here's Derard with it. Moving it to Petura. She misses the pass. Callie Greer trying to pick it up, but worked against by Sailor Easton of the Muskies. Easton. Now to the right point. Tom's shot. That's blocked. And here come the Saints. Moving it out to center. It's Madden Hughes. Madden Hughes leaves it behind and stolen by Sailor Easton. Easton now churning her way up the ice. Over the line. Easton to the backhand. Now forehand. Tries to go to the deep. Lost it off her stick, but goes behind the net to Wilson. Shot front. Scores! Come sail away! It's Sailor Easton! Giving the Muskies the two-goal lead. 3:28 gone here in the second. She started the play, and she finished the play as she got the feed from behind the net and put it past Jordan Bowen, and the Muskies lead 2-0.
Boy, come sail away. I hear you there, Joey Payer.
Huge goal for the grade 9 rookie. Both grade 9s getting on the board here in this game.
Was that before Dennis DeYoung or during Dennis DeYoung? Huh?
Assistant number 15, Emma Wilson.
Goal 16, Wilson. So it's Easton, Sailor Easton from Emma Wilson at 3:32. And now another chance, a backhander by McCoy. Pat saved by Mullen. And the Muskies now, after really being in their own end for most of the early part of the second period, have now turned things around, have got the momentum back with that goal, and looking for more. So it's been the young guns here tonight for the Muskies. Bella Fries and Sailor Easton, two of the four grade nines on the squad with the goals in this crucial early season Norwasa matchup. And the Muskies lead 2-0. Here's Sophie Muse now. Her shot blocked nicely by Blair Cross. Lucas Engberg gets it, moves it around, and it's going to be Fry picking it up on the left wing side, moving it out. She tries to send it into the Saint zone, but that's knocked down. And moved out to center now by Hughes. Hughes cuts into the middle, trying to get the pass across. That was knocked away. Turner's shot, that was blocked. Farrington's got it. She'll move it ahead. Racing up is McQuaker down the right wing side. She'll dump it in and then head off for a change. Saints back to retrieve it, and it's Turner. Turner now. Her pass blocked, but Rohde's going to get it on the right wing. And now move it up ahead. That pass misses Callie Greer. She sent the puck on net, stopped by Bliss. Muskies get it. And Ella Evans looking to move it out of the zone. Evans watched there by Hughes, though, having a little bit of trouble controlling it. Tange gets it. She'll get it out to the neutral zone. Sent back in by Turner, delayed offside. Muskies will clear the zone. And now Tange is going to bring it out. She sends it in all the way into the Saints' end, around the boards. Hustling in is Hayden Allen on the forecheck. Saints fork the puck out into the Muskies' end of the ice. Tange's got it. She's being checked, though, by two Saints. And now a turnover in front. Trying to get it there to Hendy, but Sinclair had her tied up. And now here comes Emma Wilson. Wilson off the boards. Easton now chasing into the zone against Derard. Can't quite catch up to it. Saints will pick it up. Move it back out to center. Tom. Her pass misses the Calder on the far side. White gets it, slams it in. And now Tom will get it. Send a long pass up ahead to center. That's intercepted by Derard. Easton tried to track it down. Now Tom's got it. Tom now. She tries to move into the zone, but she is stripped of the puck. And coming away now is Muse. Sophie Muse tried to make a move. Nice play there by Calder to stop that play. Saints still on the puck, though, in the Muskie zone. Derard, the long shot. Stopped in front. Hits a skate. Battle in front for the puck. Tom and Savage trying to work free to for that puck, but the Muskies come away with it. Trying to clear, don't quite get it out. Here's Sophie Muse, shot! That's blocked, nice play there by Sienna Tom. Saints still with a puck deep in the Muskies' end. Centering try, stopped by Marley Bliss. And now she has the puck taken away by Hughes. Centering. Chance for Andy Greer. Couldn't get a stick on it. Calder now. Muskie's a little bit sloppy here in their own zone. And a turnover by Calder. Backhand save by Bliss. Calder, an uncharacteristic turnover, gave it right to Maddie Hughes. And Hughes walked in on the backhand. And Bliss with a huge blocker save to keep it a 2-0 game. Icing being called now against the Muskies. 7:26 gone in the second period. Fort Francis 2, St. Thomas Aquinas 0.
Oh, smart play there, icing the puck too. You know what we could use in the press box, the West End Motors press box?
What could we use?
Some Coca-Cola beverages.
Not a bad idea.
Of course, Coca-Cola is a proud sponsor of Muskie hockey, and thank you to Coca-Cola Distributing. But how about getting a cooler full of Coke up in the West End Motors press box?
Well, we'll have to talk to those folks about that. Maybe we can make that happen. Coke Zero for me, though. I'm watching my weight. Here's Farrington. Trying to move it out of the Muskie end. McQuaker as well. But we've got Callie Greer in there. Four-player battle. Now puck comes loose. Trying to move it ahead are the Saints. Into the, along the end boards, a centering pass. Hughes was in front. Couldn't quite get much of the puck on that tip play. But another turnover. Muskies very sloppy in their own zone here in the second period. They've got to tighten that up. They've got the 2-0 lead. But these Saints can pounce in a hurry. Rhodey's got it in the left wing corner. She's bodied off the puck by Farrington. But she can't clear it out. And Samantha Neal hammers it around the boards to the far side. Muskies will try to come around the left wing side. They get it to Fry. Fry up to Farrington. That goes off her stick. Deflects into the Saints end. Neal's got it. She falls to her knees. Can't quite clear it out. Fry's got it behind the net for the Muskies. Oh. Centering pass. Another chance. Farrington hammering away at the puck. And Jordan Mullen with an absolutely huge pair of saves. Stopping Kira Farrington right on the doorstep. And the Saints lucky to come away, still down only 2-0. 8:29 gone here in the second. Farrington, two goals in the border battle last week against International Falls, leading the way for the Muskies. Also did a fine interview on Coach's Corner Saturday morning as well for us.
She did. I got good news for you on our next break.
All right. Sounds good.
No, it's not because I'm leaving. I got some good news.
Wouldn't want that. Not ever. Ever, sir. Here's Evans into the right, in the Saints zone. Now Kenny slams it towards the net. Covered by Moen. And she'll cover up and be safe with 8:58 gone here in the second. Mr. Bullseye, please hit me with this good news.
We don't have time right here, but we'll get to it. Sorry,
okay,
Matt.
All right.
Yeah, this break of the action is brought to you by Lowry's.
I thought you were going to tell me my Oilers were already leaving Chicago, but that game hasn't even started yet. So, and I'll be kind to not bring up the Oil Wild game from the other day because I'm too kind, too good of a guy for that.
Bad reffing in that one, I'll tell you that, Joey, right now.
I love the fact that the Vikings and the Wild won by the same 3-0 count on Sunday. That was absolutely hilarious.
Isn't that funny?
There's a shot by Wilson right on goal by Moen. And she makes the save and holds on. Yeah, I think maybe, I don't know, Vikings sign Kaprizov. They might be able to get a few more points there. Kaprizov 3 for the Wild and the Vikings 3 off the foot of Greg Joseph. And that was about it.
Yeah, Kirill has been struggling a little bit. He'll find his game. I'm not worried about him, but a lot of people are, unfortunately.
Meanwhile, my Oilers, 7 wins
in a row.
Yeah,
what happened? What were you talking about at the beginning of the year, though? Let's get back to Muskie hockey. Huh?
Well, we'll talk that in the intermission.
Yes.
Muskies at the blue line now. Jersey Rose with the puck, left circle. Gets a shot up towards the net, goes wide. Wilson's got it in the right corner, bothered by Sundin. Puck's in up the left side boards. Saints trying to clear it, but Tom pins her. The forward trying to move it out. That was Hendy. She just put an absolute brick wall up, and Hendy went no further. As the puck sent in on goal to Moen.
Ready for the good news, and she didn't. She released it.
Here's puck at center. Calder for the Muskies to Tom. Tom up to McCoy. McCoy tried to feather it over to Bliss, but that went under her stick. Pope in on the left corner tried to center it. Intercepted there by Houts. Houts can't clear it. Lucas Engberg, the long wrister off the glove of Moen in behind the net. Bliss now. Watched there by Turner. Turner moves it around to Edison. Muskies, though, keep it in. Now another chance. Houts can't clear it out. Lucas Engberg, the wrister, puts in the slot shot. Just wide. Oh, Marley Bliss. Golden opportunity in front. Puck sent out just across the line. And it'll be Calder with the puck at center for the Muskies. Up to Bliss. Bliss puts it into the Saints' end. Put back out to the neutral zone, though, and here's Hindy. She fires it down deep in the Muskie end and then goes for a change. 9-10 remaining in the second period. Fort Francis 2, St. Thomas Aquinas nothing. Long pass in ahead by Cross, but that missed Farrington, and it goes all the way down the ice for icing with 9:05 left here in the second. I think I just booked my plans for Christmas morning. My dogs got me up at 5. No excuse, I can't be listening in 7. Puck's head down the ice. Another icing call against the Muskies with 8:52 remaining here in the second.
Sponsors from
Homeland Financial, yes, watching on home, Muskie Girls Hockey on home TV. Certainly, again, glad you're tuning in on the stream here tonight. Glad to be, you know, certainly glad to help the radio people and give them something to listen to, but certainly having that video an extra help and something special for the kids and the relatives to tune into and check back on later. Saints now with the puck in behind the Muskies net, trying to center it out front. Bliss, though, intercepted that, knocked it away. Saints, though, putting on the pressure, centering pass, Rohde, the backhander, that goes wide. Farrington chases it there, puts it off the glass and ahead and out. Now, McQuaker into the Saints zone. She gets around Patura. McQuaker looking to center it. That was intercepted, though. Nice defensive work exhibited by Callie Greer. Now she moves over to Rohde. Rohde sends it in behind the net. Saints are going to change. That's going to give the Muskies time to bring the puck out. Sinclair, long pass ahead to Fry. Goes off her stick, but she'll chase it down. Fry the shot. That goes wide of the net. Coming in, though, on the right wing side is Kenny. Kenny, she sends it behind the net, but Samantha Neal waiting for it there for the Saints. She'll move it ahead to Savage. That goes off her stick. Calder's got it. Calder now working against Savage. Now it's Allum off the skate of Kenny and into the Saints zone. Hustling back for the Saints to get it is Kipling against Allum, but Allum's got in behind the net. Now Neal takes it away. Tries to clear the zone. Can't. Tom will keep it in. Send it in deep. And Neal looking to move it again. She does, up to Greer. Greer, the pass ahead, that goes off the stick, the flex into the Fort Francis zone. That went off the stick of Savage. Calder trying to clear it. Tom now being bothered by Addie Greer. Addie Greer sends it to Savage, the shot. Stick saved there by Bliss. Another chance, loose in front. Puck comes to the line. Neal keeps it in. Nice play by Samantha Neal. And the Muskies will grab it and send it out. And here's Ella Evans with it. Evans. Moving up there with Allum. Puck put into the Saints zone. Savage working against Allum. Now it's Evans in there. She's pushed down to the ice. And puck cleared out to center. And it's Lucas Engberg back for the Muskies. She moved long pass ahead to Emma Wilson. Wilson gets it. Moves into the Saints zone, into the right wing corner. Trying to get in behind the net. Worked over there, though, and has the puck stripped off of her. Nice defensive work there by Sophie Muse. Muse now trying to rush into the zone. Puck taken off her stick. Callie Greer loses it. Muskies looking to move it out. Dangerously bounces out front. Hughes with it now for the Saints. Left wing corner. Hughes trying to get it around to Rohde. Cross, though, cuts that off. Easton moves it to Wilson. Wilson to Easton. Easton now. She'll skate up the center. Send it in. Lost her footing. Turner's going to pick it off in the Saints zone and moves it quickly ahead to Hughes. Hughes in across the line. Hughes stops. Centers. Here's a chance. Shot by Rohde. Big save by Bliss. Rohde maybe had a little more time on that than she thought. Could have walked in a stride or two more, but decided to went for the quick shot. And Maddie Bliss with the huge stop for the Muskies. Saints now in their own zone. Send it around the boards. Callie Greer. She can't get it past Sinclair, but it deflects off Sinclair and over the glass. Faceoff should come outside of the St. Thomas Aquinas zone. 5:30 to go here in the second period. Fort Francis 2, St. Thomas Aquinas nothing.
You know, news is, looks like, is it Coach Sinclair of the boys team?
Chris Sinclair, yes.
Yeah, he is going to join us with a couple, three players for Coach's Corner this coming Saturday. Are you in for that?
I think since we're not doing swimming now, I believe there yes, we I go. Should and be able Ed, to be over for that.
Then Ed Gackley, our newest member of the KSTM KGHS Lakes Country team, will be joining us as well. So I think that's going to be you and Ed going forward. So
all right then, I'm looking forward to meeting Ed and teaming up with him. Sounds like a great, it should be a great combination.
I think so, and Ed's well known in the Fort Francis area, and wish him nothing but the best.
Excellent. Saints rushing into the Muskie zone. Muse backhands it toward the net. Puck still loose. Here's Sinclair picking it up for the Fort. Moves it up to McCoy, to Bliss, and now to Pope. Hannah Pope, one of the rookies on this Muskie team. She makes a great move inside on Turner. Tried to take it to the net. Just slid off her stick at the last second. Puck in the Saints end. Tom keeps it in for the Muskies. Gets another shot. Tries to send it toward the net. That goes wide. Bliss is going to chase it down, though, on the left wing side. Marley Bliss, bothered there by Savage. Saints are going to come away with it, and it's Muse leaving it for Savage. Backhands it out to center. Calder's going to grab it from the Muskies. Has it go off her stick. She's got to chase it back into her own end. Jersey Calder. Chased there by Addie Greer. Spins away from the pressure. Sends around the boards the other side to Bella Fry. Fry now. She went for the long pass up to Farrington. That didn't work.
Uh-oh.
As DeRoyard intercepted. And now here comes Hughes. Hughes, right circle. Steered off to the corner by Calder. And then taken out of the play. Great defensive play there by the Muskie captain, Jersey Calder. As she stood strong against Hughes. Here comes Bella Fry now. Strong in on the right wing for the Muskies. Fry taken out of the inboards by DeRoyard. Tried to center it. And went off the pad of Moen. She had to clear it to safety quickly. Hughes now around the boards up to Callie Greer. Greer moves it to Rohde. Rohde fires it in deep and goes off for the change. Muskies with time to move it. 3:27 to go in the second period. Muskies 2, Saints nothing. First place on the line here in Norwasa in early season showdown between two of the top teams in the conference. Neal with the puck for the Saints. Moves it over to Addie Greer, left wing boards. She sends it out. That goes off the stick of Muse into the Muskies' end. Chasing back is Cross. Cross backhands it around. That's going to get intercepted by Savage. She leaves it behind the net. Saints looking to move it out front. Now the long shot. Kipling, that hits the stick and goes wide. Addie Greer's got it behind the net. Watched by Lucas Engberg. Greer tried to put it in front. Savage now. Muse alone in front. Savage tried for the wraparound instead. And that was steered away by Marley Bliss, helping out her sister. Now, here's Addie Greer. Pass across. Intercepted by McCoy. Neal was pitching in from the left point, and they cut that one off just in time. Puck at center. Muse has got it. Put it in deep. And it'll be Blair Cross chasing it down for the Muskies. She'll backhand around, but didn't look where she was sending it. It's intercepted there by Zavea White, the hero of that playoff semifinal last year, as she scored the shootout winner in the 10th round to eliminate the Muskies.
Gosh, she had to bring that up, didn't she?
Loose puck in the crease. Bliss jumps on it and holds on. Now a bit of shoving going on in the paint, but nothing looking to come of it. 2:02 left in the second period. Muskies lead 2-0. All right, Saints with a puck in the Muskies' end. Rohde's got it, left side corner. Watched there by Sinclair, tries to spin away from the pressure. Rohde making a couple of moves there, but eventually double team, and Farrington comes away with the puck, moves it up to Bella Fry. Fry, left wing side, skates it out, now sends it in deep, and bounces off a stick. McQuaker's got it for the Muskies in the right corner. Tried to center it, intercepted there though by Rohde. She'll move it ahead to Hughes. Hughes was stopped up in the neutral zone. Puck set back into the Saints' end, and it'll be Alexa Houts trying to move it there for the Saints. Callie Greer tried to tip it up the left wing boards. Now the Saints are going to get it, move it out to center, and it's Rohde with it. Rohde, she'll just send it in deep, go off for the change. Muskies grab it in their own end. And here's Fry with the puck. She'll send the long pass across. Now here's a chance. Courtney McCoy walking in. Shot stopped by Bowen. 1 minute to go in the second period. A great late period chance for the Muskies. Off the stick of Courtney McCoy. Now here's Muse trying to move her way in. Her shot was blocked. Stuck with it though. Puck backhanded on goal by Addie Greer. And Bliss covers up for the Muskies with 42.5 seconds left. McCoy had to do a little bit of a catch-up on that play. Didn't get the full breakaway that she wanted, but still had a good chance walking in, and a big save there by Jordan Bowen. Muskies get control off the draw. It's Tom, moves around the boards to McCoy. That's going to go all the way down the ice. Looks like we're going to get another icing call against the Fort. 32 seconds left.
Some more good news for you. Okay. Going forward, not so much in this game, but as we get to those three pucks of the game, right?
I
squash that. That is gone.
Can I give you a big high five for that?
Thank you. Because you're going to have to talk about that. It's going to be a three stars of the game.
I love that.
Okay.
Because it's the old tradition.
Yes.
I love old
that
tradition.
That brought to you by Stratton Equipment. We will have those three stars tomorrow during the 7 a.m. and 8 a.m. sports if Don gives me some time to do it.
Excellent.
So,
excellent.
Again, our three stars of the game brought to you by Stratton Equipment.
You know what? The tried and true is sometimes always the best.
I don't even know what I was thinking.
It's okay. It's all right. We got it figured out. Yeah. Here's McCoy now. Allum with the puck at the Saints zone. Allum walks in. The shot! And I think Moen got a piece of that just to send it wide. Allum now tried to center it. 8 seconds left. Saints, one more rush. Going to get a shot off. They will. Right in on goal on Bliss. Long shot by Rohde. Deflected to the corner. And that is going to do it. So the Fort Francis Muskies, one goal in the first, one goal in the second. They have got the St. Thomas Aquinas Saints backed up into a corner and are heading to the dressing room with a healthy advantage. But do not discount these Saints. They are a threat, and they'll be bringing all the fire in the third period, to be sure. For those of you watching on Home TV, Muskie Girls Hockey brought to you by Homeland Financial. We will be back with you for third period action in just a little bit. And for those of you listening on radio, we will be back with the intermission in just a second after these commercial messages. Your score after two periods at the Ice for Kids Arena in Fort Francis. The Fort Francis Muskies 2, the St. Thomas Aquinas Saints nothing. You're listening to Muskie Girls Hockey again on Home TV, brought to you by Homeland Financial, and on Lakes Country 104.1 FM.
Muskie girls.
Bella Fry in the first, set up by Carson McQuaker. And then the second period goal for the Muskies, Sailor Easton, set up by Emma Wilson to give the Muskies that 2-0 lead. Not a Muskie power play yet, but possibly for coming in the third. We'll see how it goes. Third period action here on Home TV, Muskie Girls Hockey, brought to you by Holman Financial and on Lakes Country 104. Point one is underway. Muskies with that 2-0 lead over the St. Thomas Aquinas Saints. And it's the Muskies sending it deep into the Saints end to start things off. Kipling grabs it there for the Saints. Moves it around the boards to Neal. Neal, she tries to go up to Callie Greer, but that's picked off by Courtney McCoy. Now, Marley Bliss working in against the puck. Neal gets it. Gets it back to the points. Kept in by Lucas Engberg. She'll fire it deep into the left wing corner. Coming away with it now, Rohde. Rohde just out across the line. Muskies clear the zone. McCoy's got it for the fort. McCoy working against a couple of Saints defenders. Hughes and Muse trying to work the puck off of her. McCoy stays after it. Puts it off a skate into the corner. Farrington's going to chase it down. Left corner, back to the left point. Tangay's got it. Tangay fires. That's blocked. Saints come away with it. Rohde's got it. Sends it over to Hughes. Right wing boards. Hughes will bash it off the boards in and go for a change. And it's Sinclair back for the Muskies. She goes up the left wing side. That's intercepted by Heidi Petura. And now at the line, it's Muse with a puck. She works in across the line. Muse shot. Blocked by Farrington. Goes into the corner. Saints trying to center it. It's Gerard backhanging into the right corner. Centering pass. Pad saved by Bliss. It was a pass, but it ended up being more of a shot. Went right in on goal. That might take it by Addie Greer, and Maddie Bliss kicking it out to the boards on the right side. Puck sent down the ice. Looks like we're going to have icing against Fort Francis. 1:45 gone here in the third, and the Muskies continue to lead the Saints 2-0.
This Coca-Cola, I guess, breaking the action because we're thirsty. We need the cooler up here at the West End Motors press box. That will happen. I'm going to talk to Jay next week. We'll see where it goes anyways.
Petura coughs up the puck. Here's a chance for the Muskies walking in. It's Kenny. Pass across and hits the stick of Gerard to Fry, but she leaves it for Allum. Allum, the backhander. That's just wide. Allum slams it on net. Saved by Moen. Battle along beside the net. Now the net looks like it's off, and it will be whistled down. But what a chance. Muskies almost had a 2-0 going there if they'd been able to get into fourth gear in time. But Gerard made a nice play on the back check to tip away the pass across. Muskie still put a little bit of pressure in on that opportunity, but unable to convert.
In their head, they want to do something, and then it has to go to their hands and then their feet. Okay, so just a slight second tick can make a difference, but really good to see them thinking on the ice, and that's my point.
Muskie get the draw. Allum's got it. Goes to the back end in the slot. A backhander right on goal. Save. Loose puck. Allum trying to stuff the rebound home. Was unable to. The Saints will pick it up. Saints now looking to clear the zone. Can't do it, though. Here's a chance. That goes off a stick. L. Evans with the shot. Deflected to the end boards. Now it's Savage for the Saints. Racing up the right wing side. Savage moves it to Muse. Muse to Addie Greer. The shot. Saved by Bliss. Rebound. What a save by Bliss. She did not even see that one, I think. Slammed on goal by Muse. And the stop. Now a shot with a point. High over the top of the net by Turner. Here come the Saints, as expected, down 2-0. They were going to bring the A game here in the third. Looks like that is the plan, delayed offside. Muskies have a chance now to move it out. Here's Jersey Calder, Calder off the boards into the Saints end. Grabbed there by Turner. Turner up to Sundin. Sundin moving in across the line. Drops it for Hendy. Hendy's shot. That's wide of the net. The rebound under the stick of Edison. And it's Jersey Rose with it. Rose, though, turns it over inside the line. Hendy shot. That goes wide. Lucas Engberg with it. Moving it up ahead to Wilson. 50-50 Kipling cuts it off in the neutral zone. Rose gets it. Puts it ahead, and now Kipling's got it in her own zone. Kipling to Edison. Edison to Sundin. Sundin. Nice back check by Emma Wilson. Took the puck right off of Sundin and moved it back into the Saints' end. Samantha Neal sends it ahead. That misses everybody, and it's going to be an icing call against St. Thomas Aquinas. 3:46 gone here in the third period. Fort Francis 2, St. Thomas Aquinas nothing.
Fort Francis, I think you mentioned it perfectly, as they can't hold back. And I think overall it's been pretty good. They're still attacking, and I know that's what the coaches are telling them, but sometimes the instinct is still kind of play back and play defense.
No, but the opportunities, they have been taking the opportunity to forecheck when they've had the chance, for sure. Also like the back checking by both sides tonight as well. Loose puck, where is it? In the crease. Oh my goodness, that puck deflected out of nowhere from the inboards right into the crease, and Jordan Moen had to be ever so careful on that one to keep that out. That could have been a backbreaker there for the Saints if they caught that one up here to go down by three. Muskies win the draw now. McCoy, right corner, centering pass. That misses Evans. Rohde gets it off the glass. Can't get it out. Nice kick play by there by Tanya to keep it in, but the Saints get it out to center eventually. Bliss now to Evans. Now Marley Bliss with the puck. Bliss, far side, McCoy. She's trying to cut inside, taken away by Neal. Sinclair backhands it in. Neal's gonna pick it up there. Rohde's got it. Up to Callie Greer. Greer, the backhander in on goal to Maddie Bliss. She'll stop it. Send it along to Sinclair, to Courtney McCoy. McCoy, right wing. Puts it into the Saint zone. Patera picks that one off, and it gets sent out to center. Now Muskie's trying to turn it the other way. Can't do it. Here's Farrington with it though. Backhander, Gerard stops her. And it's Addie Greer now, left wing side. She's got a little bit of room. Addie Greer, great back check though by Carson McQuaker, just as we were talking about. Loose puck sent across the crease. No one there for the Saints. Muskies get it, send it out ahead. And here's a chance maybe. Bella Fry racing after. Can she get there before the icing? She does. McQuaker's alone in front, the pass. And what a block there. Heidi Petura. As Carson McQuaker was wide open in front, waiting for that one. But couldn't, the puck could not come through. Saints now looking to move it out. McQuaker keeping the pressure on for the Muskies. Here's Addie Greer. Can't get it out. Tom right in on goal. Loose puck for Fry. Oh, and one shot, and then a second one just wide. Sit, but the Muskies stay on it now. Here's Calder with it. Calder skating with the puck all the way around to Farrington. Trying to go back to Calder, but that'll be picked off by Addie Greer. And she'll move it out to center, moves it ahead. Trying to get it up to Muse. That pass didn't work. Muskie sent it into the Saints zone. Here's Heidi Petura. Petura, the quick pass up nice to Rohde. Rohde, left wing. She'll fire it in deep around the boards. Hughes will try and track it down on the right wing corner. Now Callie Greer comes to help. She gets it to Rohde. Rohde tried to go to the net. Stopped there by the Muskies. Allum moves it up to Ella Evans. She can't get it past Turner, who tried to shoot on goal, but that was blocked before it got to the net. Callie Greer moves it to Hughes. Hughes, the centering pass, nobody there. Lucas Engberg will pick it up and race down the right side. Pass ahead, looking for Evans. That pass misses everyone, and it'll be icing against the Muskies. 6:31 gone here in the third period. Muskies 2, Saints nothing.
Joey, I don't know when they plan on doing a rematch or the next game between these two teams. I'm guessing in Kenora, but I would really like to carry this game somehow, somewhere, and sometime. So I know you'll get me some details on that, but I think it's important. This is some good hockey.
Info, absolutely. They're back and forth, and again, very, very close in terms of talent-wise, these two teams. Going at it hard, and not a lot to pick from when it comes to settling it out. Now here's Marley Bliss's shot. That's blocked by Delaney Turner. Sending behind the net. Saints trying to grab it there. Here's Turner with it. The Saints trying to move the puck out. And it's going to be a little bit of a wait there for that next game, but it will be January 30th in Kenora. Muskie's going to St. Thomas Aquinas. Shot on toward the net, deflected by McCoy over top. Now looking to center, it's scores!
That was a right shot.
How about a wraparound special? Courtney McCoy fires it home between the wickets of Jordan Mullen. And with 12:38 left in the third, the Muskies with a massive insurance goal. It's 3-0.
Yeah, McCoy made no mistake. And I wasn't sure if it was 20 or 10, but then it was the right shot showed me it was McCoy. And, wow, what a great play. And, you know, a shot on net, it's not a bad shot, right?
Never a bad
that's game. The way I look at it. So Courtney McCoy, yes, 3-0, Fort Francis takes the lead.
So it's McCoy unassisted at the 7:22 mark of the third to give the Muskies a 3-0 lead. And now the Saints are really going to be up against it. But here they come, looking to get on the board and give themselves some life. Neal keeps it at the left point. The long shot, tip goal. What a save by Bliss as Eddie Greer, deft touch with the stick in front. And Matty Bliss staying with the puck the whole way. Best stop of the night for the Muskie goalkeeper. Saints keep it in the Muskie end.
Wow.
Here's Calder now. Moves around the other side to Carson McQuaker. McQuaker off the boards and out to the neutral zone. Big chance there for the Saints, but Matty Bliss shut the door and keeps it a 3-0 Muskie lead. Here's Jersey Calder with the puck in the zone. She turns it over though. Puck's in on goal. That was fired by Callie Greer, stopped by Bliss. Now Hughes with a long shot. That goes over top of the net. Callie Greer is gonna chase it on the right wing boards. Send it in behind the net. Here's Hughes with the puck now. Hughes trying to work past Tom, centering play. Rohde's got it now, left wing corner. Reese Rohde, she's stopped. Gets it back. Two Muskies on her. Now Neal's gonna pinch in from the point. Neal's shot, that hits the stick of McQuaker, deflects to the boards. Fry trying to move it out past Callie Greer. Great forechecking by Callie Greer on this shift. Muskies now, Jersey Calder with it. She'll spin away from pressure, goes off the boards, looking to move it out, Fry. Can't get past the Saints. Great forechecking here by St. Thomas Aquinas. Putting on the pressure, looking for a much needed goal. Down 3 with 10:35 to play here in the third. Kept in at the line. Heidi Petura walks to the middle. Fires. Deflected. Loose. That went off the stick of Greer. Went just wide of the net. Centering pass. Petura's shot. Saved by Bliss. Calder now off the boards, fires it down the ice, and the Muskies will take the icing call with 10:15 to go here in the third. A mammoth amount of pressure put on by the Saints, but they cannot crack the armor of Matty Bliss, and the Muskies lead 3-0.
Saves of the game brought to you by Valley Adult Learning Center. Let's get a goal tonight on that. That's a whole different thing. It's a power play. I can't even make it up. Thank you to Valley Adult Learning. Hey, we got our three stars after the game and our player of the game. We'll get to that after. Joey, you take over.
All right. Muskie sent it down into the Saints. And another icing call, though. So 10:04 remaining in the third.
You know what I do on icings when I'm at home?
What do you?
I run to the icebox. What do I get at the icebox, Joey?
Something healthy, I hope.
Yes, of course. Coke Zero.
There you go.
Or a Diet Coke or a regular Coke. Anyways, you get the idea. Coca-Cola from International Falls sponsors Muskie Hockey, and thank you to them. How's that?
I haven't seen your fridge, so I just have to take your word for it. There may be other people that are doubting this, though they're listening. I don't know. Here come the Muskies in the Saints' end. It is Evans trying to keep control of the puck, but Muse has got it. For the Saints, she tries to move it out. Intercepted though, Hayden Allum trying to go to the middle. She had a shot off, that's deflected, goes wide. Saints grab it, fired around the boards to Addie Greer. She looks to move it out and does. She'll come up the left wing side, send the puck deep into the zone. Muskies will chase back for it. It's Blair Cross with it. She's bumped and a battle there with Callie Greer. Allum's got it now. Cross around the boards to Lucas Engberg, far side. Saints will keep it in. Houts sends it in deep into the corner. Hughes chases after it. Rohde trying to get in on the play. Two Saints on one Muskie. Lucas Engberg, though, doing well to fight them off. Turner tried to slam it in from the point. Couldn't get it on net. And here comes the Muskies. Marissa Kenny, she'll dump it in, go for a change. Emma Wilson chasing in on the forecheck against Alexa Houts. Wilson's got the puck. Sends it around the boards. McCoy's going to hustle against Rohde, trying to keep possession of the puck for the Muskies. Saints come away with it, though. Patera fires it around. Stopped up there by Sinclair on the pinch. Sinclair is going to keep it in at the right circle. Sends it in behind the net now. Wilson, she's got an assist tonight. Wilson up to McCoy. McCoy with the goal here in the third period. Muskies can't get the puck to the net yet, but Tangi is going to try now. That deflects off of Muse and heads to the right corner. Wilson's got it. Wilson, bodied there by Houts. Marley Bliss with it. Bliss trying to center it to McCoy. Goes right to the base of the net, and it's Moen covering up and holding on. Good shift there for the Muskies. 8:08 left here in the third. Fort Francis 3, St. Thomas Aquinas nothing.
Mike Ballstedt and Joey Payer live up here in the West End Motors press box. For new and used vehicles and full service repair department, get a hold of the West End Motors. Go see Guy and the staff. You know Guy, right?
I know. I think I know Guy.
Yeah, good guy.
He's a good
guy.
Guy
Clem.
Oh, yes, definitely a good guy. Know his family well, actually. All good people. Here is the Saints now. In behind their own net. They're going to look to move it forward. Samantha Neal with it. She'll send it up to Addie Greer. Gets it out to the neutral zone. And now maybe a chance here for Sophie Muse and Greer. Here's Muse walking right in on goal. The backhander scores! That is a power forward move.
Yeah.
If you ever saw one, Sophie Muse giving some good news to the visitors. They're on the board. 7:45 to go in the third. And they are fired up on the St. Thomas Aquinas bench. And they have cracked the code of Maddie Bliss. Finally, it is Muskies 3, Saints 1.
Yeah, she's been good all night, Hughes. Also, Hughes has been good. It's kind of a rhyming names, but it kind of rhymes with news.
It does.
Where did
it
you
all fit
get
together.
That? Where are you getting this stuff at?
Off the top of my quickly balding head.
I'm telling you, you're practicing at home.
Well, there's a saying that goes along with being lucky, but I'm not going to put it on air. It's not polite.
No.
Hughes with the goal. Addie Greer with the assist. And Ayla Savage as well getting the second assist. So Hughes from Addie Greer and Savage at 12:15 to give the Saints some life. Here at the IFK, it is still the Muskies up 3-1. Puck tipped deep into the zone. Fry trying to chase it down before the icing. Can't quite get there, though. And the faceoff will be back down to the Muskie end. And we're going to see just how much momentum St. Thomas Aquinas gets off that goal. The Muskies knew these girls were not going to go away. The Saints have been on their heels and neck with them all last season, all this season. The games have all been tight. And I don't think anyone on that black and gold bench was thinking this was going to be a cruise home here for the rest of the third period. And that has been proven true as the Saints back in this hockey game down 2. Muskies now trying to turn things around. Fry stopped up in the neutral zone, tried to move it ahead, but it's Heidi Patera with the puck. She'll send it to Hughes. Hughes across center. Stopped up there. Nice play by Lucas Engberg. And it's Kenny with the puck. Kenny, her pass. Little behind Fry. Fry will stay after it, send it in deep. 6.5 minutes to go here in the third. Fort Francis leading 3-1. Winner of this game gets first place by themselves in Norwassa. Kenny now checking in behind the net against Patera. Allum stops up that rushing attempt by the Saints, but Saints will send it down into the Muskie end. No icing on the play. Ophelia Lucas Engberg back for the Muskies. Good skater, the veteran blue liner for the black and gold. That pass misses Kenny, and it will be an icing call again against Fort Francis with 5:56. I thought there was a tip at center, but officials apparently saying no, sir, and we'll have the faceoff in the Fort Francis end.
Well, again, still a two-referee system, which I really like. First off, it keeps down on expenses for the schools. Secondly, I think that's all you need on the ice. I mean, sometimes you get too much reffing. takes away from the game.
Exactly. Shot right on goal. Save, rebound. Oh, what another save.
Man.
Sundin jumped on the rebound of the point shot right on the doorstep, and Matty Bliss got the pads down to make the stop. Oh, would it have been a different ball game if the Saints put that one home with 5:45 to go in the game. But it is still 3-1. Matty Bliss has been top flight here tonight for the Fort Francis Muskies. As the veteran goalkeeper has kept her team ahead after grabbing that early lead in the first, building on it in the second, more so in the third. She's given up one here in the third, but a couple of big saves there to keep it a two-goal contest. Puck back in the Saints zone. Here is Delaney Turner with it. She goes backhand to Addie Greer and now up to Muse. Muse across to Sundin. Sundin, who was just robbed by Bliss a minute ago, puts it in behind the net. Calder picks it up for the Muskies, gets it to McCoy. McCoy up ahead, nice pass. Marley Bliss, 2-on-1 with Emma Wilson. Tell Wilson, walking right in a goal, the shot! Big save, Jordan Moen. Wilson taking the feed from Bliss, moving in on the left wing side all alone. Went for the quick shot, and Jordan Moen coming up with a key save for the Saints. 4:42 to go in the third. Muskies lead 3-1.
Yeah, I got it on the kind of the end of the stick, which kind of cost her probably an excellent scoring chance. But yeah, great play there by Bliss.
Didn't get all on the shot, all of the shot for sure. Wilson wanted, but still a tough stop for Moen. Here come the Saints now. Rohde, right wing corner, spins around, tries to center it. Here's a chance. Hughes, her shot was blocked. Samantha Neal now takes a shot that goes wide into the far corner. Tom and Hughes racing after it. Tom wins the race. Trying to get up high to Fry, but the Saints move it down deep in the zone again. Rohde's on it. The ever dangerous Reese Rohde. Puck sent out to the neutral zone though by the Muskies. And now here's Fry trying to steal it. She does. She'll put it in behind the Saints net. And we've got 4 minutes to play here at the Ice for Kids Arena. Fort Francis 3, St. Thomas Aquinas 1. Norwasa showdown for first place. Hold on, folks. We're in for a heck of a finish. Pucks in down the ice, and it will be icing again against the Muskies. 3:47 remaining. Now, question is, when will head coach Dave Turner decide to pull Jordan Moen and send in the extra attacker?
Well, Patrick Waugh's kind of changed that part of the game around about 7 years, 8 years ago, and they're pulling him at all stops right now. So I would expect about the two-minute mark, though.
Here's the Muskies with the puck in their own zone. Moving it out to center. Pachura stops that play. Puts it back to the Muskie line. Lucas Engberg gets it though. Nice pass up to Evans, but she was intercepted. Now here's Ayla Savage. Savage, right wing side. Backhands it in behind the net. Blair Cross hustles back there for the Muskies. Watched there by Addie Greer. Savage back there as well. Puck loose. Now Allen's gonna get it. Go off the boards, can't get it to Evans. Loose puck, here's a chance now maybe for the Saints, driving the net. But they were unable to convert on that one. Muse looking for her second strong goal of the period, but couldn't get the puck in on net on that play. Evans now in behind the net. Saints take over, move it up, and here's Muse. She'll try again. Muse, nice stick play there by Tange. Take it off her, and it is an offside as Muse was in ahead of the play. Tried to seal it, but could not retain possession. It was offside called. Yeah, 2:51 to go here in the third.
Coach Turner has been looking down there. Still no move. I'm kind of surprised at that, Joey. I can see one goal, but two goals down, man. You probably got to pull it right now.
It's got to be fairly soon. They might be waiting for next good possession in the Muskie end to make the decision, but we'll see how it unfolds. Callie Grew tried to send the puck on net. She gets it back in the left on the left side boards. Now Saints try and center it. That was stopped up. Marley Bliss in behind the net for the Muskies. She'll move it around to McCoy. Kept in at the left line by Kipling. Muskies go off the glass. Still can't move it out. Great play by Kipling. Now she throws a decent cross check there on Marley Bliss. No call coming. 2:17 to go. Turner moving it in on the right wing side. Saints come away with it. Rohde. Shot! Saved by Moen. Sinclair will pick up the rebound. She'll go off the boards. Try and move it out. Saints now cranking up the forechecking pressure. Here's Addie Greer with it. The backhander loose in the slot. Rohde the spinorama. That stopped and sent down the ice. for icing against the Muskies with 1:53 remaining. And now let's see, will the
might get at least a timeout here, I would think. But again, no goalie.
No timeout and no move yet by Moen. No, wait, now here she comes. Just as I say that, Moen is beckoned to the bench. And off she comes. And the extra attacker coming on in the form of Hughes for the Saints. So it will be 6-on-5 for the Saints with 1:48 to play as they trail the Muskies 3-1. This is Addy Greer behind the net looking to center it. Calder's got it though, protects the puck. Working against two forecheckers. Farrington back there trying to help her out. Loose puck and Farrington comes away with it. She'll go off the glass. McCarker's gonna get it out. She's gonna move it down the ice but didn't catch center. And it's gonna be an icing call again against the Muskies with 1:21 remaining.
Yeah, definitely didn't try to do that. She just thought she'd hit it high off out the glass. Now I expect a timeout here.
It is a timeout by the St. Thomas Aquinas Saints. So
a whale of a game. Not disappointed, Joey. You made the right call on what to do here, so good job with that.
Thank you so much. Just want to make mention of the two teams' coaching staffs for St. Thomas Aquinas this year. Dave Turner, the head coach. Assistant coach Sean Hughes. Assistant coach Montana Neal, also the trainer on the team, and manager Jody Valena for the Muskies. Head coach Shane Bliss this year, joined by assistant coaches Jordan Larson, Taylor Croswell, and assistant coach and trainer Ann McEwen. And I was talking to Ann before the game. She's very excited. You know why? Because at 6 a.m. tomorrow, she'll be getting up and flying down to Phoenix, Arizona to join her parents for a month down in the Arizona sunshine. So as excited as she was about this game, she was even just as much excited about catching that bird down south tomorrow morning. So happy for her. Ann is one of the absolutely most wonderful people in this community. Longtime OPP officer, Ontario Provincial Police, and just absolutely.
Is that the one on the left from here?
That would be the lady in the cap. Yes, on the far left there.
Yeah, right? She helped me get the interviews last time. So
yes.
I'll be doing that after the period, Joey.
Excellent.
You kind of do your stuff.
I'll
finish
do my
it
thing
out,
up here.
Right?
Wait for you to come back. And we're not going to play those in the post game. We're going to save those for the
morning
show.
We're saving for the morning show.
Very good.
Just too difficult to hook up, and then we take chances getting disconnected. And I don't want to do that. That'll be the next group that does it.
Understood. I'll lock the doors and turn out the lights. Don't worry.
You do the outro, get us out of here. Make sure you do that outro.
We got her covered. We got her
all
covered.
All right, buddy.
But meanwhile, we still got a hockey game. The net is empty for the Saints. Muskies over the chance. Marley Bliss can't control the puck in the Saints zone. Hughes going to get it, slap it behind the net. And we have 1 minute to play here at the Ice for Kids Arena. Muskies 3, Saints 1, empty net. Saints making a last push. Addy Greer sends it in behind. The Muskie net. Lucas Engberg gets it there. Trying to feed it out. He's going to come back to the right point. Patera's got it. Patera almost lost it to Bliss. Just kept it in and sent it into the right wing corner. Rohde's bodied off the puck. The long shot opportunity by the Muskies. That's going to be icing as it was Blair Cross looking for the long distance empty netter. And now we're going to have a timeout in the Muskie bench called by head coach Shane Bliss.
Definitely know what Blair was trying to do, but maybe a little coaching thing, maybe angle that a little bit and try to avoid that icing call.
Yeah, absolutely. Want to save those icing calls and less face-offs your own zone, the better.
Joey, we got our three stars. Who do you got? We're going to see
how
much we agree on.
The way I'm looking at here right now, I'd certainly be going Number three star? Oh, no, I was going
to
go from top down.
Let's go top to bottom.
All right, top to bottom. I'd certainly go with Maddie Bliss for the Muskies as first star.
I had her at like two or three, the way she stopped things in the third period, she's moved up to one for me as well.
Absolutely. Great night for her. I'd certainly go with Bella Fry at number two.
I like the people who score first goals. I'm going to give her number two as well. She kind of turned the thing. You got the thing going in the fourth way. What do you got for a third?
Well, now are we being like unbiased and looking at both teams for these stars?
We are not.
We are not.
We're biased.
We're going full Muskies. All right. Then
for a better show in the morning.
Then I'm going to go ahead and say Jersey Calder, who's been really strong in the back end.
Look at
this. You go three for three?
Well, I like the big, strong defensive person in the back, and she's been there all day.
Yeah.
And she's a senior, so
absolutely.
I'll try to get all three girls on for interviews after the game.
Perfect. Excellent. Here's Marley Bliss with the puck deep in the Saints zone. Just 20 seconds ago, the Muskies on the cusp of a 3-0 Norwasa record and taking over its top spot all by themselves. Centering pass, scores! Marley Bliss on the feed from Kira Farrington.
Well,
parks it in the empty cage, and it's all over but the crying as Marley Bliss salts this one away with 10.5 seconds remaining, and the Muskies take a 4-1 lead.
Yeah, I mean, just to me, she's always going to be either your top one or two players on the ice at all times. She might not score every game, but you're always going to notice her, and she's a player. I like her a lot.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Muskies' fourth goal is scored by number 7, Marley Bliss.
Bliss with the goal. Farrington with the assist. And the buzzer sounds, and the Fort Francis Muskies pour off the bench to celebrate with goaltender Maddie Bliss as they capture a big 4-1 victory over the St. Thomas Aquinas Saints from Kenora. And the Muskies move to 3-0 on the regular season and take over first place in Norwasa Conference. For those of you who tuned in on Home TV, Muskie Girls Hockey brought to you by Holman Financial, thank you so much for watching, and we do hope to have you back for the next game. And those of you listening in Radio Land, we are going to be back with the post-game show momentarily. Your final score from the Ice for Kids Arena, the Fort Francis Muskies 4, the St. Thomas Aquinas Saints 1. You are listening to Muskie Girls Hockey on Lakes Country 104.1 FM.